बच्चों, जो भी एडजेक्टिव है या जो भी ग्रामर है, वॉट एवर वी हैव डन प्रोनाउन्स और या कुछ भी जो भी है, वॉट एवर अप टिल नाउ वी हैव डन नाउन प्रोनाउन एडजेक्टिव्स है ना, इफ क्लॉजेस, यू विल गेट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एरर्स। ओके, एरर्स या फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स और ओमिशन और जम्बल वर्ड्स है ना, कंस्ट्रक्ट सेंटेंसेस जम्बल्ड। सो दीज आर द टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दैट यू विल गेट इन ग्रामर। ओके, एंड देन चैप्टर, ऑफ कोर्स यू नो द नेम्स ऑफ द चैप्टर्स दैट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट इन एग्जाम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस दिस इज जोड़ी रिस्पॉन्स। ओके, नाउ व्हाट हैड हैपेंड टू जोड़ी फादर, व्हाट वाज द नेम ऑफ जोड़ी फादर, यू रेज योर हैंड दोज हु वांटेड टू अनुश्री, व्हाट वाज जोड़ी फादर।
Father's name was Penny, and Penny was bitten by the red raccoon.
Yes, his father's name was Penny, and he had been bitten by a, I think, two, because I've opened two meetings, that is why I'll try and close the I'll just switch this off. Okay, now is it okay? अभी आवाज आ रही है? अब
यस मैम।
एको तो नहीं हो रहा?
नो मैम।
नो मैम।
तो क्या था? इट पेनी एंड पेनी हैड बीन बिटन बाय अ स्नेक। सो व्हाट डिड जोडी, व्हाट डिड जोनी जोडी डिसाइड टू डू? What did Jodi decide to do? Yes, Mahip, you have given
फोन हंटिंग।
yes, Elsa? अच्छा, Shivan has also raised hand. Shivan?
I mean, want to go and they hunt for hunting.
ये दक्ष जो है, दक्ष, you are talking too much. So behave yourself, otherwise I'll silence you. Then you won't be able to give any answer. Yes, हाँ, रिपीट योर आंसर स्नेहन और शिवन।
He go to hunting.
युक्ता हैज गिवन टू ब्रिंग द फोन एंड टेक केयर ऑफ द फोन। एनीवन एल्स हु वांट्स टू गिव द आंसर? एल्सा? यस एल्सा,
He went to bring back the phone to take care, and because it was their responsibility as they killed the its mother.
yes, now Adaksha has also given and Elsa has
To
given
bring him
the answer.
his
Yes,
for
he
his
wanted
mother.
to bring the fawn, take care of fawn, because they had killed its mother, and it was their duty, moral duty. He thought it was a moral duty to take care of the fawn since they had killed the mother to save Penny's life. Now next question, what was the, when he told Penny about it, that he wanted to bring back Penny, he wanted to bring back Fawn, what was the reaction of Penny? Was he happy? Did he readily agree? Yes, Ahana? Did he agree, Penny?
Afraid.
Yes. Yes,
Yes,
Neha?
ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Daksh, why are you giving wrong answer? Yes, he agreed because he was
Yes,
happy
ma'am.
about it. What is the action of Mrs. Buxter, his mother? When she came to know, he agreed, he gave permission, and then when he wanted to ask permission of his mother, what was the reaction of mother? Dipanshu? Dipanshu? Dipanshu, you can give the answer, you have raised your hand. Ahana? Dipanshu, either you give the answer or Ahana, you give.
Ma'am,
Yes, she, when she came to know, or when he told her, I think my voice is reaching late.
ma'am, shall I
Okay, Anushree.
tell? His mother was shocked, disappointed, and anxious.
Yes, not disappointed, she was shocked, taken aback. Remember, she was holding that tea, was it coffee mug or a tea mug?
coffee pot.
Pot. So she held it in the air. She was taken aback. And then she agreed after he told her that he would take care of the fawn. Okay. So who went with him when he went to search for fawn? Who went along with him? Milville or Dr. Wilson, you can say either Dr. Wilson or Milville went with him, and they went on a horse. And after he had reached the forest, or when he was just near that place or the spot where he had left the fawn, what did he tell Mr. Wilson? What did he tell Mr. Wilson? Ahana, what did he tell Mr. Wilson? Elsa is getting ready to give the answer. Yes. Samia, you want to give the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what did he tell Mr. Wilson?
Ma'am, Dr. Wilson mean that they must have to pay the price of the doe, and as they had killed his mother.
That is what I think he had told his mother, Anna, Mrs. Boxter. Now my question is different. I'm asking, when they reached the forest, Harshita, when he had reached near the spot where they had left the fawn with the mother, what did he tell Wilson? I'm waiting for you to give the answer.
He said that he will go by foot.
Yes. Virat, Milville, you should answer. Virat is saying you don't ask me. Yes, Virat. Virat, give the answer.
Ma'am, he said that the jungle is a denser, so he will look for the fall alone.
Yes, yes, very good. That he would, he can leave him alone. Yes, the scrub is too thick. Okay, Snehal, correct. So he asked him to leave him alone. Now he could take care, and it was dense. The horse would not go in this thick forest. So he asked him to leave him alone. And first he was hesitant, Mr. Wilson, but then he left him. And why did he ask Dr. Wilson to leave him alone? My next question, why did he ask Mr. Wilson to leave him alone?
Can I?
Yes, Elsa.
He didn't want to share the sweet meeting with the fawn if he found it. And he didn't want Milville to see his face disappointed if the fawn was not found.
Very good. Anyone else who wants to give the answer? Good, Elsa. Yes, anyone else who wants to give the answer? Raise your hand. Yes, anyone
else? Ma'am, he didn't want to share his happy
okay, and
disappointment.
Okay, yes. I think some children have raised their hands. Okay, Virat is saying same answer. Yes, anyone else who wants to repeat? Daksha is also saying same, ma'am. Day means same. Okay. Yes. Snehal, you want to give the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Snehal, repeat the answer.
If the fawn was dead, could not be found, he could not want him to see his disappointment. And if the fawn was there, the meeting could be so lovely and so secret that he did not want to share.
Very good. So these were the two points that he has mentioned, that he didn't want to share if the fawn was not alive, or he did not find the fawn, then he didn't want Mr. Wilson or Dr. Wilson to see the disappointment on his face. And if he found the fawn, the meeting would be so enduring, so sweet, that he wanted to did not want to share it with anyone else. Okay, so these were the two reasons why he sent Dr. Wilson. Okay, so finally, he had reached the spot and he couldn't go directly. So he went around in the clearing. And then he finally found the fawn. Can you describe the meeting of the fawn, the meeting between the two, between Jordi and the fawn? Describe the meeting between Jordi and fawn. Yes, Nehal. Again, Snehal wants to give the answer. Yes, Nehal. Snehal, you had raised hand. Harshita has also raised hand. Okay. First, Snehal, then Harshita. Snehal?
Ma'am, I have not raised.
Okay, Samia, you give the answer.
I have to answer.
Ma'am.
Please repeat the question.
Describe the meeting between the 8 minutes, Samia. Describe the meeting between the fawn and Jordi. Yes,
Jordi could not trust himself to move.
Harshita is giving the answer. Huh, Harshita?
Ma'am, the meeting was lovely. Jordi could not trust himself to move.
Okay. Yes, you want to disturb the fawn that it may get frightened. Okay. Yes, Navya.
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, Navya.
The fawn lifted its nose and sniffed him. Jordi put his hand on the soft neck of the fawn and the touch made him.
Yes.
Delicious.
Yes. Ma'am, can I answer?
Okay, Samia.
Ma'am, on reaching the forest, Jordi guided Melville to the spot where Penny had been bitten. This was also spot where his father had killed the doe. So here he thought deeply of the fawn.
No, I think Elsa, repeat your answer, what you had given, the meeting. The meeting, Elsa. That paragraph where the meeting takes place, when he finally finds the fawn.
By seeing the fawn, Jordi became very happy, and the fawn lifted its nose to smell Jordi, and Jordi put his hand on the soft neck of the fawn, and this made the fawn very delirious, and that's it, ma'am.
Yes, and then he picked it up gently, as if though it was of China bone. Yeah, na? Okay, so very precious. So, Samia, this is the answer what Elsa has given. I think you find this in paragraph and read that paragraph. Okay, the meeting was very sweet, or he looked at it gently, and the fawn also looked at him with his liquid eyes. Isn't it? Those lines have been given there in the chapter, that paragraph. And he picks up the fawn very gently, as if though it is very precious. Yes, Kritika, with a stare of its liquid eyes. Yes, liquid eyes, beautiful. That phrase, liquid eyes. Okay, he could feel the spread. Fawn didn't feel secure to go with Jordi because he thinks that Jordi is a stranger. Shivin, ye kahan se likha hai?
Ma'am, ye bhi to sakta hai ki wo Jordi ke saath insecure ho, feel kar raha ho. Secured feel nahi kar raha ho.
वो भूखा था, बिना माँ के था, तो वो देख रहा था कि कोई सहारा मिले. और जॉर्डी, और वो ना जॉर्डी उसको डिस्टर्ब नहीं करता. जैसे अभी एल्सा ने रीड किया ना, कि वो रीड किया था पैराग्राफ, है ना, अफ्रेड दैट इट वुड गेट फ्राइटेंड. सो इट इज वेरी साइलेंट एंड वेरी सॉफ्टली इट टचेज हिम, ही टचेज द फोन, है ना, जेंटली petting him. I think you have got a book, so you can read that paragraph. Elsa, tell them the paragraph and the page number.
Page number 91, third part of the lesson and the last paragraph.
Okay, go through that.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, page ma'am. 91.
It's given that the
page
that all of you. So that was the meeting. And then he carries him gently, he lifts him so that it would not get hurt with the branches or the shrubs or the thorns. And he just carries him, and then when he comes to the crossing where the roads, it's clear, the forest clears, he puts the fawn down, thinking it would follow him. But when it did not, then again he picked him up for and walked, holding him to some distance, and then again he left him down, and then the fawn followed him to his home. Did the fawn climb the stairs? Did the fawn climb the stairs when he reached home? Did the fawn climb after him the stairs? No. Ritika and all, no. You answer no.
No, Jordi.
Why?
Pull him.
No.
Why couldn't it climb the stairs? You wanted
because it was too weak and young.
Yes, it was too weak. It was too weak and too young. Remember, small ones or the young ones of animals, they have to be taught by their mothers. Yeah. So it was too young and too weak to climb the stairs, and then he carries him to his father's room, and his father is very happy. Then he teaches him to drink milk. How does he teach him to drink milk? Yes, Shivin? Kaun answer dena chahta hai sabse pehle? Let me see who raises the hand. Anushree. Yes, Anushree. How does he teach
him? Jordi picked up the phone.
Lakshita, after this, Lakshita will repeat. Yes, Anushree?
Ma'am, he fed the fawn by his hand. He dipped his fingers in the milk and poured it into the fawn's mouth.
Yes. And thus, he taught him to drink. Yes, Yukta poured his fingers in the mouth or put his fingers in the milk. Yes, Yukta. And the fawn drank the milk. Put his fingers and then put his... Yes. Ahana, you want to give the answer? You just... Yes, watching everybody give the answer. Yes, Ahana.
Yes,
you give the answer in your own words.
Yes. Jordi dipped his fingers in the milk pot and thrust them into the fawn.
Yes, thrust them. In his mouth. Then, when he pulled his hands out of his mouth, it began to. It seemed it wanted more. Then he again dipped and then he let his fingers in the at the bottom of the milk, isn't it? At the surf, and the fawn began to drink from the tumbler or from that gourd, G-O-U-R-D, gourd. Jis mein rakha hua tha na, usme milk. Yes, Elsa, you want to give the answer?
No, ma'am, I want to give the answer.
Anushree ka haath upar hai aur Samia ka hai aur Tanisha ka hai. तो हम कहां से शुरू करें? सामिया से शुरू करते हैं. यस सामिया.
यस मैम. मैम एट द फर्स्ट द डियर कुड नॉट ड्रिंक फ्रॉम द गोर्ड. जॉर्डी डिप्ड हिज फिंगर्स इन द मिल्क देन ही थ्रस्टेड देम इनटू द फॉन्स माउथ. इट सक्ड ग्रीडीली. नेक्स्ट टाइम एज द डियर सक्ड हिज फिंगर्स ही लोवर्ड देम इनटू द गोर्ड. दिस वर्क्ड. द फॉन बिगेन टू सक फ्रॉम द गोर्ड.
So this is the answer. Anushree, repeat it. Anushree, you have raised your hand. Yes, Anushree, you have raised your hand. Repeat the answer.
Yes.
So I think some network problem. Yes, Anushree.
In the milk and on it looked greedily. Then he withdrew them, ignited frantically, and put it in.
Correct. Yes, Tanisha. Tanisha, your hand is raised.
Yes. He dipped his fingers in the milk and thrust them into the fawn's soft mouth.
Phir? Ye to adhura hua, ek hi sentence hua. Yes. फिर उसके बाद क्या हुआ?
मैम ही सक्ड ग्रीडीली व्हेन ही विथड्रू देम इट बेल्ट फ्रेंसिजली एंड बट हिम.
हां फिर ये दो तीन सेंटेंस फिर क्या क्या उसने? तनिषा, अरे हु विल रिपीट द होल आंसर? अहाना गिव द होल आंसर. सामिया एंड अनुशी आल्सो गिव. तनिषा ने थ्री सेंटेंसेस दिए हैं. अल्सा रिपीट द आंसर होल कंप्लीट. Complete answer, Elsa. How did he teach him to drink milk?
First, Jordi dipped his finger in the milk and sucked it greedily. And then Jordi lowered his hand to the gourd and
yes,
drank from the gourd.
Can I repeat?
This is the way which it
okay. I think it's given in the last.
Can I?
Yes, Shivin. Shivin.
He dipped his fingers in the milk and thrust them into the fawn's soft, wet mouth. it sucked greedily when he withdrew them. It bleated frantically and butted him. He dipped his finger again, and as the fawn sucked, he lowered them slowly into milk.
Okay, so this was your chapter, Jodi and his fawn, Jodi's fawn. Now we go to the poem. Then I set out for Linus. Who is the poet? Who is the poet of When I Set Out for Linus?
Thomas Hardy.
Yes, Thomas Hardy.
Tanisha. Thomas Hardy,
the great novelist, is the poet of this poem. And what does he say? Where does he go? Where does he go?
He is going to Linus.
Why? Linus, he goes. Why? Why does he go to Linus? Let me see who.
To supervise.
Anushree?
To supervise the restoration of the church.
Please repeat the question.
To help in restoration of the church. Isn't it? Okay. What does he say? Yes, Elsa, will you repeat the answer? Why does he go to Linus?
He goes to Linus to supervise the restoration of a church in line.
Restoration of the or reconstruction of the church, like Yukta told, restoration or reconstruction of the church. Okay. He goes there. Yes, Manmendra, you're also correct. I think this is better if you're typing now, so I can read out your answers and your name also. It comes quicker. Those who can type, it's okay. Those who want to give oral, that is also okay. So he goes to Linus. And what does he say that nobody would be able to predict? What people would not be able to predict? He says something at prediction that nobody, neither the poets, no, he says prophet, any prophet, magician or learned man could predict. What does he say? What they could not predict? What they would not be able to predict? Okay, Ritika, glow on in his eyes. The change. And the change that would he would experience, they would not be able to predict, or they were not able to predict the change.
They would not be able to predict what will happen when he will stay there.
Very good, Lakshita. Ahana, you also had raised your hand. Yes, Ahana.
Yes, ma'am. They would not be able to predict the change he will undergo.
Transformation, a change, transformation or the change, okay, that occur when he stayed there. Yes, okay. So that was, he says in the poem that they would not be able to predict. And when he came back, what did the people notice when he returned from, yes, Elsa. Elsa is the first one to raise, and then Tanisha. Yes.
A mute surmise.
Okay. Yes, Tanisha. Magic in his eye, Anushree, Yukta. A magic glow in his eyes, magic in his eyes. Okay.
Magic in his eyes.
There was some magic. There was glow in his eyes. The peace, hai na? The inner glow. And it was immeasurable. The enlightenment he had, hai na? And that brought the change in him. Okay. So I think this is over. Anything else you want to ask from this poem? Is it clear, this poem? You can go. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can always ask. Then a visit to Cambridge. Okay. Now, in visit to Cambridge, what is the name of the writer?
Firdaus Kanga.
Yes. Firdaus Kanga.
Ma'am.
What does he do? What is his profession? What is his job? Yes, Snehal. Snehal?
He was a writer.
He was a writer. Okay. Journalist, isn't it? Reporter, journalist, a writer, and yes, what was his problem? What did he suffer from? Elsa?
He was differently abled.
Yes, Yukta. Yukta has given a correct answer. Tanisha, what about you? Yes, Yukta, very good. Yukta. Aditya.
Brittle bones.
Yes, he suffered from brittle bones, and that is why he could not move freely. He moved on Yes, Anushree Manvendra, he suffered from brittle bones and he had to move in a wheelchair. And he went all the way from India to England. And then he uses metaphor. What is a metaphor? He compares, he calls Cambridge.
Cambridge
England.
Was
for England, Cambridge for England, yes. Why he uses this word? Yes, for him, Cambridge was metaphor of England. Yes, Anushree. Why does he use this?
Famous for Cambridge.
A small Cambridge, okay. A town, a small town. Cambridge is a town. And it's a university, greatest university. And moreover, the person whom he admired. Whom did he admire most?
Stephen Hawking.
Yes, and he not only lived there, but taught at Cambridge. So that is why he used the metaphor for Cambridge for England. Now, next question. How does he get the permission? How does Firdaus get the permission? Can you describe?
Yes, telephone.
Yes, yes, he rang up. And how much
he rang up and he said ki his household worker told the permission.
Assistant. Yes, assistant told him that he would be given only half an hour from 3:30 to 4. And yes, Virat, Yukta, 10 minutes. Okay, 10 yes. minutes. Okay. He said he wanted so desperately to meet him that he asked him, pleaded only for 10 minutes. But assistant said that he was given half an hour to be with Stephen Hawking. And he felt very excited. And then he asked different questions and he finds, what did he find, Stephen Hawking? Who will give the meeting? Elsa wanted to say, Elsa? What does he say? In short, you can give the answer. Yes, there are different questions. The whole chapter is on the questions he asks. Yes, Elsa. Okay, what does he compare him with? He compares him with something. He compares Stephen Hawking to?
A lantern.
Yes, who gave this
lantern? My name, Virat Joshi.
Very good, Virat. He compares him with a lantern. Now, can you describe this? A lantern. Yes, Manvendra. Can you describe? Who will describe this? Description. Comparison. Comparing. Yes, Virat. Virat.
Ma'am, he compares Stephen Hawking's outer body as the glass of the lantern and the fire inside it as the
glow, the soul.
Yeah, the soul in it.
Yes, very good. So he and irrelevant, the outer walls were irrelevant. And he found him very beautiful, his one-way smile. And he found him humorous, yes, witty. And he gave him nearly 1 hour. And he also took him at the end to see his garden. And the meeting was a great success. He was very happy. So these two lessons will come from your reader and this poem, one poem. And then from supplementary, you will get the fight. Okay, so how much time is still there? I think time is up. 46.
Yes.
So be ready. Yes, and next time when we meet, you can come with your doubts. Yes, he compared the inner fire of lantern to the inner power in Stephen Hawking. Very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
So
thank you, ma'am.
We'll do the revision of fight. So come prepared with fight. Read it carefully. Okay, the fight. And also, come with your doubts. If you have any doubts, you come with your doubts. Okay, and then we'll take up new lesson. We'll start new lesson. I'll share with you on WhatsApp. Okay, so bye.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, bye.